you everybody for coming out today. This is a lot more people than what we thought we originally anticipated. That's great. We're glad to have you all here. They've been working real hard on this presentation, and they're all real excited to roll out the Wizard of Oz for you guys. So without further ado, Wizard of Oz.
This story is about a little girl who lives in Kansas. Her name is Dorothy Gale. Dorothy finds Kansas very plain, very dull, and very, very boring. She often daydreams of places that are more exciting, more adventurous, and more colorful. Some place like over the rainbow. One day, Dorothy decides to take a walk with her dear little dog, Toto. While picking flowers, she begins to daydream about places she could be besides boring old Kansas. Then suddenly, she starts to notice that it's turned chilly, dark, and windy awfully quick. She looks off into the distance, and to her surprise, she sees...
Twister!
She quickly runs back to her home, Toto to try and take cover from the one destructive tornado. Then suddenly the tornado swoops down on Dorothy's house. With Toto wrapped tightly in her arms, Dorothy can do nothing but stay in the house and wait for the vicious tornado to stop. The twister finally comes to an end. As soon as Dorothy thinks it is safe, she walks outside. She stops in awe. She notices that she's in a very different place.
Toto, I don't think we're in Kansas anymore.
Dorothy walks around in amazement, wondering how she could have gotten to such a beautiful, colorful world. Then suddenly, she thinks to herself that this must be it. She must be over the rainbow. Suddenly, she notices a figure coming toward her.
Who are you?
Glinda.
Glinda went on to explain to Dorothy that she is in Munchkinland. She had just saved all the Munchkins from the horrible Wicked Witch of the East by having her house drop on top of her. Glinda then assures the Munchkins that it is safe to come out and meet the girl who had saved them.
Come out, wherever you are, and meet the young lady who came from the star. She fell from the sky, she fell very far, and Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
She brings you good news, or haven't you heard, when she fell out of Kansas, a miracle occurred.
No miracle, what happened was just this. The wind began to switch, the house to pitch, and suddenly the hinges started to unhitch. Just then, the witch, to satisfy an itch, went flying on her broomstick, thumping for a hitch.
And oh, what happened then was rich.
The house began to pitch, the kitchen took a hitch. It landed on the wicked witch in the middle of a ditch.
Joyous news we spread, the wicked old witch at last is dead.
Dorothy, extremely frightened, told the witch that she didn't mean to do it and it was just an accident. Linda then reminds the witch.
Aren't you again something? Whispers. Where are they? You're too late.
Linda points to Dorothy's feet. The witch grows furious.
I'll kill you. Do what? You have no power here. Two. What? On you.
The witch, scared she'll meet the same fate as her sister, begins to leave, but not without warning that she'll give back those ruby slippers if it's the last thing she ever does.
It's pretty and dog too.
The witch leaves. The witch leaves and a calmness comes over everyone again. Dorothy is very frightened and now just wants to go back home to Kansas where she feels safe. Dorothy asks Linda.
Wizard.
Glenda explains that she must go to the Emerald City and visit the great and powerful Wizard of Oz, and that he can help her get home. Dorothy asks. Glenda assures her that the Yellow Brick Road will take her right to the Emerald City, and just so she doesn't get lost, assigns a munchkin guide to accompany her. So Dorothy sets out on her quest to find the wizard and get back home to Kansas.
Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow, follow.